French study, sitting there between these piles of paper and the books in disorder across the back. If you compare it with some of the portraits of German philosophers of time, like Jaspers, he's always sitting upright in front of straight up and down lines and books on the bookshelves. So let's return to Kenneth White and Heidegger. White points to the ways in which Heidegger moves from seeing philosophy and poetry as two parallel paths to a wayfaring into primal space, and to a later realization that only poetry exists on lasting ground. If, for a start, he welcomed this encounter as the occasion of a fertile dialogue, seeing poetry and philosophy as two neighboring but separate peaks, he gradually came to see a closer connection, if not an identification. The end of that with wayfaring into primal space, White wants to designate in German as Westland, a land where es West, where there is being, a being deeper than anything envisaged or experienced in ontology. And I think, and you can correct me, that Heidegger is actually the most important existential influence on Kenny's thinking and on the relationship between human beings and the natural world. The search for that deeper being, this is Kenny again, is what connects wayfaring, travelling the land, to poetry, the search for the poetics of being. Now, Heidegger was very much present here in Glasgow as a result of the work, particularly of John Macaulay, who was teaching Heidegger in the 1950s, but also through the influence of the theologian Ian Henderson, who's one of the main promoters of Kierkegaard, but was also closely engaged with contemporary developments in German theology.